Hey, what's up, everybody? True Boxing here. Thank you for coming back to Get Hit with the Truth. So today, the video is Ortiz versus Martin is on. This is a big, in my opinion, it's a big heavyweight fight to determine, you know, basically, you know, who gets back into the title hunt. You got Luis Ortiz, a former two-time world title challenger. His only two defeats at the hands of Deontay Wilder. You know, also this fight, this fight is taking place on Saturday, January 1st, and it's on a Fox Sports pay-per-view card. It's actually an all-heavyweight pay-per-view card. You got Frank Sanchez battling Carlos Negron in the co-feature. Pretty solid, solid matchup right there. So, you know, decent heavyweight card. We'll see how much it is. I'm leaning towards most likely not ordering this card, but, you know, we'll see how much they're charging for it and everything that day. But I do like the matchup for Luis Ortiz and for Charles Martin. Charles Martin, former world champion, very brief. He only held the title a couple months, and the way he won the title was by an injury TKO when he beat, what was that guy's name? I don't even remember the guy's name when he beat him in January. I believe it was 2016. And then just 3 months later, he got knocked out against Anthony Joshua and lost the title. So he is the very definition of a paper champion. But to be honest, I never thought Charles Martin would resurface again. I thought it was a one-off. But Charles Martin, back in 2020, last year in February, actually on the Wilder Fury 2 undercard, he knocked out Gerald Washington, who's a former world title challenger. Decent heavyweight, nothing special with Washington, but, you know, he's a guy who hits hard and you know, has been in there with Deontay Wilder and different guys like that. You know, he was actually doing all right against Wilder before Wilder knocked him out. So the fact that Charles Martin came in, had a game plan, boxed, set it up, and knocked out Gerald Washington was impressive last year. And now, if he's really the next, you know, if he's really a legitimate heavyweight, that top 10 guy, he's going to beat Luis Ortiz, because I got Ortiz still in my top 10. You know, he hasn't fought since November of last year, has Ortiz, but Ortiz is, you know, a hungry dog. He's one of those boxers that I call my guys, because Ortiz has been widely avoided. His nickname is the Boogeyman. I mean, he's the real King Kong, but he is the Boogeyman of the heavyweight division. Even after the loss to Deontay Wilder, he's still the Boogeyman of the heavyweight division. Wilder knocked him out twice. Second fight, he knocked him out clean, but he was getting beat on points, just like he was the first time when he knocked him out. But, you know, outside of those two losses, Luis Ortiz has been widely avoided. And you ask yourself, why? The guy is 42 now. He's not fast in terms of speed, but I'll tell you what he has. He has great boxing ability. He's a smart fighter. He's a southpaw, and he's a big guy. You know, he's 6'4", and he hits like a fucking ton of bricks. Luis Ortiz hits very hard. His knockout ratio is insane. This guy is a real, real contender and tough as hell. And, you know, he's one of those guys that he's so talented, in my opinion, overall, that you almost wish he would just be world champion just once. Almost like Charles Martin. Charles Martin became a paper champion and can always say, hey, I was a world champion. I wish Luis Ortiz had that distinction, because he's so good and he's been so widely avoided in his career. And it's sad, but, you know, be that as it may, he's coming in, he's trying to get right, he's trying to get back in the heavyweight title mix. You know, at some point, those belts are going to be vacant, and they're going to be, fought for by top contenders, and this is the kind of fight that gets you into a title eliminator, a final eliminator. They could end up making this a final eliminator, you know, but it gets you to that next level in the heavyweight division, and I'm looking forward to it. I like Luis Ortiz a lot. Charles, he's 42, trying to climb back into the title picture. Really, for Luis Ortiz, it's probably his last hurrah. One more title shot is probably what he's going for. Hopefully, third time's a charm. And then he's facing Charles Martin, who's a former champ, who just wants to get another crack at a belt at some point. He's 35. You know, he's coming into the fight. He's taller. He's a 6'5", or Luis Ortiz 6'4". He's got a couple inch reach on Ortiz. So is he going to try to do to Ortiz what he did to Gerald Washington? You know, we're going to see. But I'll make my breakdown video on this fight right around the beginning of December, maybe a little bit after beginning of December, because the fight doesn't take place till January 1st. But I'm really looking forward to it. You know, they're starting to announce the fights for next year, for the first part of next year. They're starting to get announced now. We're a couple months away. So I'm looking forward to it, though. It's a nice heavyweight matchup right here. Fox pay-per-view, January 1st, you know, New Year's Day. Don't miss it. It should be solid. You should have a good time watching it. So I'm really looking forward to it. I hope you guys enjoyed this. True Boxing, you've been hit with the truth.